Good morning, it's Rude, reusers of unloved discarded excess. And today we're going to troubleshoot a sewing machine with Rude Boy for Agatha. Rude Boy, let's start.
All right, put your machine on settings that you know work. Straight stitch, make sure they're located properly. Remove your bobbin. I haven't done it, but remove your needle. And that way there's nothing attached to the machine that should be fouling it. So with all that mechanism, what do you call it?
The shuttle.
The shuttle and all that, get it out. So there's just the back of it in there on this. You've got to take screws off, but on your machine, you don't, it'll all remove. Now, once you do that, obviously see if it turns, and if it's not turning, obviously it's something in the machine that's failing. So you know it's not the needle, you know it's not your shuttle or your bobbin. Maybe look for, if you've had a broken needle recently, it might have finally fouled down in here. So you can remove the top plate with your screws, have a good look, tip the machine up, have a bit of a shake, see if you can get anything to drop out, but really have a good look because they can hide really well. And on this Husky, it's not the same as yours, but it's really just to show you that the mechanism of a machine is, you've got gears driving yours, this is belt driven, so the gears, this bottom one here, this shaft here, actually drives your bobbin, and this shaft here drives your top part of your machine. So it's just not, those gears might be jammed. It could be something up here that's jammed or something down here that's jammed. So it's just not, have a good look at the gears, make sure there's nothing in the little cogs.
Like a broken needle.
Well, a needle shouldn't be down this end, but,
oh, all right.
But who knows, a bit of spring, a screw, anything could have dropped down there. But I doubt it.
Now, what about screws? Because I know I've had some screws before that have come off, yeah? Not screws, springs.
Springs, yes. See, this one's got springs here. Springs here. Springs here. And look, it shouldn't...
Where are the springs? You're too fast.
Here.
Oh, yes.
Here. Now, I'll use... Oh, yes. Here's my pointer. There you go.
Yes. That they could easily come off, couldn't they?
Yes, one there, and there could be others. Yeah, there's another one. So just have a bit of a look, see what's around. Probably not, but I don't know everything about these things. Might stop the mechanism, but you're saying that when you roll it forward, it locks. So that's telling me that something's not moving out of the way for the shaft to turn. Because you can roll it back a little bit, but when you roll it forward, it locks up. So you've got to find if there's a lever, maybe in here, you've got to have a really good look to see if you can see any part of the machine that actually is locked in to stop it rolling forward. So, but as you can see, you've got the up and down movement here.
Wait a sec, where?
In there.
Yes.
Right. So that shouldn't really, on this, if it was happening, I could disengage this top belt and that would isolate just the bottom, but then you'd put it out of timing. So if you're taking any golf, make sure you mark it. You mark it. So, but if you're going to go that far, I wouldn't do it if you weren't quite comfortable with it. But really, all this is to show you is that just don't look in the part where the gears are. The gears obviously drive the shaft, which operate your shuttle and bobbin. And that obviously drives your top for your needle and your stitching pattern. So basically, look outside just this part here, because it drives everywhere.
Yes, and it could be anything.
Could be anything. It could be a little lever that's sort of locked in because the gear's fallen off and you don't want this. You could have a loose screw on a shaft, which has put it out of sync.
So how does she check for all these screws? Because there's a lot of screws here. Do you just sort of make sure they're not loose, yeah?
Well, if it's loose and it's shifted, you're out of sync, so... But it shouldn't really jam the machine, though. So there's your, like a locking screw for this shaft here. You've got one, two, three of them on there.
Mm.
So that's how important it is.
So what?
And here's another locking screw. So...
So what if it's screws? It won't be screws, you don't think?
No, I don't think so.
Right.
I wouldn't be surprised, you know... Hopefully it's a broken needle that's just got jammed in here. For it to be working one day and not the next, that's what happened, wasn't it?
I believe that it's been working, she's cleaned it, and now it's not working.
Well, she's either dislodged something when she's taking out the shuttle, or maybe there was a broken bit of needle sitting on top and it's dropped down somewhere.
Yes. Well, you like to think of the easy things before you think of the hard things.
How true.